end was what caused me to vote to repeal it.
I was really disappointed that it was repealed. I think it's probably the best voting system that there can be.
Opinions on instant runoff voting remained mixed in Burlington the day after voters chose to repeal the system.
I don't think it's the end of the world, but I would have rather have kept it.
But in the wake of the vote, it wasn't just IRV that came under attack.
And the mayor in particular is not a good communicator. He's a very bad communicator. He doesn't communicate why ideas should be accepted by the people. And if you can't get people to buy into ideas and try and force them to take things by mandate, in my opinion, that's not good government.
City Councilor Ed Adrian has called for Mayor Bob Kiss's removal before, and the mayor's response, he has no intention to step down.
That's a sort of a ridiculous comment, but not inconsistent with Ed. I mean, I think Ed is prone on the council to sort of partisan theater.
Mayor Kiss insisted that low turnout was what pushed the repeal.
I think that it's a more significant issue than that vote reflects. And so I think it will be a discussion that we continue to have. Was that the best result?
And on this point, at least, Adrian agreed.
I mean, each ward has the same number of voters. So if this was something that people were motivated and felt passionate.
Adrian is the only city councilor who has gone so far as to call for the mayor's resignation, but other councilors have expressed sentiments of unhappiness within the city in the wake of this vote. As for IRV itself, it won't officially go away until the state legislature approves a change to the city's charter. And the next step, Bob Kiss says he will explore the idea of a 50% majority, not the 40% set to take effect. Live in the Vermont newsroom, Jill Glavin, News Channel 5.
Well, Jill, as you touch upon there, Governor Douglas is hopeful that the legislature acts quickly and changes Burlington's charter so that IRV does, in fact, become a thing of the past.
I don't support IRV. I don't think it's a real election. It's a sort of hypothetical one. It's where you have to choose your second and third and fourth choices. I really think the election process ought to be real, ought to be contemporaneous, ought to be a real choice among candidates.